Hello everyone! Again I'm going to use the circle technique. Yeah, I'm calling it a circle technique. I don't know another name for it. But this time I'm using a new Geode coaster mold I got. And I'm going to use the same resin and white paste as in my previous video. But now I'm going to use other colors. So in this video you can watch me make the Geode coasters from start to finish, as I always do, with the end result also in this video. So for the new people to my channel that like tutorials of resin in this case, but also acrylic, alcohol ink, mixed media, you name it, consider to subscribe, click the notification bell and select all, because that way you don't miss anything. So I'm going to make some Geode coasters in a new mold I got, and this mold is 4-cavity, and I got it from a Dutch company called Molds and Shapes. I will put a link in the description box of their Facebook page, then you can check that out if you're curious. But I got it and it looks great, so this is the first time I'm using it, so I'm very curious if this is going to work with this mold. The shapes of the coasters are really nice. So the first color I'm using is a Bombay ink, it's the violet, and what I already mentioned, I'm using the same resin as I did in my previous video. It's a resin from a German company called Dipon, and I'm using the Epoxy Plast 100P, and it's very thin. You can see it already at the stream that comes out of my cup, that the resin is very thin. This color is also a Bombay ink, it's the magenta color, and I mix some extra fine glitter in it, also magenta, to give it some sparkle. You all know I love sparkle, so that's why I've added the glitter. And I also want to thank all the people that commented on my previous videos, and I got some really nice comments, and also some comments that they look like flowers, and I agree. They look like flowers. In the middle, some clear. Because I already know, after I did some experiments, that where you have the clear and you pour the white line on top of it, the white circles, it will sink totally to the bottom. And where the colored resin is, it stays on top. But yeah, that's what I know now. But I'm going to do more experiments and see also with other brands of resin. In my next video, I will use the Stone Coat Art Coat resin. I want to see if that makes a difference. And what also some people commented is that I also can wait until the end of the working time and then pour the resin. So I will also do an experiment with that to see if that gives me another effect. So all the materials I'm using in this video you can find at the end of the video, but also in the description box I always put the links to the websites where I buy my materials. If you're curious, then you can check out the description box. So in the middle again some flitter flakes. I like these very much. They are iridescent, very nice. Pressing it down a little bit into the resin. Yeah, and these coaster molds, they are very thick. So they are 15 millimeters. I don't know that in inches, but I think they are a little bit too thick. So that's why I'm not filling them totally to the top. So I use some heat to remove some air bubbles. Now I'm pouring some clear on top of the flitter flakes to get them all the way under the resin. Yeah, and again, it's very thin. So yeah, I don't know if this is going to work in these small coaster molds, because in my previous video I used a silicone cake pan of 10 inch, 25 centimeters, so that's very large. And I learned it's called a tri-fet. Bit more of the violet. And some magenta. More flitter flakes. So the difference is with my previous videos that the coasters are smaller, and yeah, I don't know if the effect I got in my previous video is the same, because I'm also going to use the Resin Pro white paste again that I also used in my previous video. But that, yeah, these coasters are much smaller. So we will find out if I get the same effect as I got in my large coaster. Very careful with the torch, otherwise your coaster will stick into your mold, and that would be a shame. Now I'm going to start with the white circles. There you can see it. And again, it's very thin, you can see it at a line. I need to move my hand very fast to get a straight line. Yeah, again I'm going to blow on top of the white lines to spread them a little bit, and I think after my experiment that it's also the effect you get on the bottom of the coasters has also to do with how you blow on those white lines. So I'm also going to experiment more with how to blow on those lines to create some nice effects on the bottom. Yeah, the lines get wider now. Yeah, they look a little bit messy, but hopefully I get a nice design on the back of it, of the coasters. So I'm almost done with filling the molds, and now I need to let it dry for 24 hours before I can take them out. So we are 24 hours later, and now I'm going to take them out of the mold. I'm very curious what design I get on the back. And there you can see it. Yeah, a totally different effect than I got in my previous video, but you can see that where I pour the clear in the middle, the white is on the bottom. Yeah, now on the top, but and where the colored resin is, it's not sink to the bottom, but it's a totally different effect than I got in my large coaster. But yeah, I'm still liking this effect. There you can see it. There's some great depth, and I like the flitter flakes. And I must say, they come out very nice out of the mold. They are very shiny. I like the edges. Yeah, I'm always very careful with taking them out of the mold, that I don't ruin the mold. But there you can see it. Yeah, at the end of this video, I will show you a close-up, then you can see it much better. And they sparkle a lot. I like these colors together, they are great. And I think these coasters are thick enough. I think they are 1 centimeter, I don't know that in inches. So they are out of the mold. And they look great. So the mold is, yeah, I am very pleased with this mold. There you can see the edges. Very shiny. So I'm going to experiment more with this circle technique and also with other colors, other brands of resin, to see if that has an effect on the design that I get on the back of the coasters. So this is the end result. I have them outside in the daylight, in the sun, and I hope you can see the depth, but this is a totally different effect than I got in my previous video. But I also like this. But I need to think about how I can create this effect again, because now I don't know, so I need to think about it a little bit more. But I'm liking it very much. And indeed, they look like flowers. What also some people commented below my videos. And they sparkle a lot. They are very shiny. And I'm very pleased with the mold. So if you want to know where I buy this mold, I will put the link in the description box. It's a Dutch company. You can also find all the links to the website in the description box. Also, the link to my Instagram, Etsy shop, also my Amazon influencer store. There you can find all the materials I prefer to use in my art. And I also have some promo codes there where you can get some nice discounts. They are also in the description box. So if you are curious, then you can check it out. And the Etsy shop of my associate that sells my natural mica pigments, but also my own Etsy shop, you can find in the description box. I want to thank you all for watching again, and I will see you in the next video. Bye!